This is Ganesh Shetty, sir. I hope everybody are doing good and are the best of their health and are staying safe at home. The topic that we are going to discuss today is called as black hole. Black holes are the region in space with very high gravitational force. The gravitational force is so high that even the fastest thing, that is light, cannot escape through black hole. Now, according to general theory of relativity as given by Albert Einstein, it is said that gravitational force bends light. I repeat, gravitational force bends light. So, black holes are the region in space with so high gravitational force that they bend light in such a way that light also cannot escape through a black hole. So, black holes are the region in space with very high gravitational force. Now, question is, sir, even if light doesn't escape from the black hole, how we are able to visualize black hole from the space? Now, the answer to that is, first, whenever any stellar objects comes near black hole, it will be totally absorbed by the black hole. That means in space, if we see any region that is circulating around a dark space, that region is nothing but black hole. After years of experiments, we have come to know that black holes emit X-ray radiations. So suppose in space, if we get any radiation, any X-ray radiation, and from an unknown dark source, that means there exists a black hole around it. Further, what more about black hole? How do they originate? So the answer is the life cycle of a star. Now, how does the star is born? For that, you have to know few basic understanding. Now, as we know, hydrogen's nuclear fusion is the source of energy of sun. Now, nebula, what is nothing but a giant cloud of dust, nebula, yes, is present in space. Now, when this nebula, the giant clouds of dust is present in space, yes, when they come close to each other, yes, due to the gravitational force, they just spin. And when they spin, they form a stellar core. Now, in this core, nuclear fusion happens. Nuclear fusion of hydrogen, converting it into helium, happens. When this happens, the core becomes more energetic and it starts releasing energy. And this leads to the formation of a star. So any star, before forming a star, it is nothing but a stellar nebula, a giant cloud of dust. And when this dust gets attracted to each other, they form a stellar core. Now the sun's life cycle is dependent on this core. More massive is the core, more bigger is the star. Now what happens after the star is born? Once a star is born, for millions or billions of years, it will survive. And one day, the core which has hydrogen in it, the nuclear fusion which happens in it, will get exhausted. When that will get exhausted, the inner core starts to crumble. When the inner core starts to crumble, the outside region, yes, will start to expand. When it will start to expand, it will cool. When it will cool, it appears what you call as a red giant. So whenever we see red giant in space, it is nothing but that the core of the stellar of the sun has totally exhausted. Now it is the outer surface is becoming cooler. So initially a stellar nebula, then it forms a star. From a star, it forms a red giant. What happens after the red giant? After the red giant, the outer core, it just gets exploded. Now, if it explodes very high, it leads to formation of what you call as a supernova. The other way, if the core stellar mass is very much less, then it forms what you call as a white dwarf. So, the first thing happens after the red giant, if the core of the sun is not too massive, the red giant will also not be massive. If the red giant is also not massive, the core crumbles and the outside part expands, leading to what you call as a white dwarf. Now, what if the stellar mass, initial core of the sun, nebula, initial stellar gas is very high? The particular red giant will be called as a massive red giant because it will be huge. Further, when the massive red giant explodes, it leads to a phenomena called as supernova. So when we see supernova in space, it means a star has exploded. Now, when the star gets exploded, yes, the core, if the mass of the core is less than few solar mass, it becomes what you call as a neutron star. It survives for some point of time and it emits neutrons, hence it is called a neutron star. But sometimes the mass, the stellar core, stellar mass of any star is so massive that even when the supernova expands, explodes, the core still has huge amount of mass, and due to which there is huge gravitation. As we know, mass, gravitation is associated to mass. More is the mass, more is the gravitation. So after the explosion of the supernova, if the solar mass, say suppose 10 solar mass, 15 solar mass, hundreds of solar mass, if it is so high, the explosion, after the explosion, the entire thing is still attracted towards a core, and this leads to form what you call as a black hole. So black holes are the black holes that we see today were once a particular star. That means all the heavy supermassive stars which are present in the universe today, one or the other day, they are going to become a black hole. Now this arrangement that we see, that a star becoming a nebula, a stellar nebula becoming a star becoming a red giant becoming white dwarf, a red giant becoming supernova, supernova becoming neutron star, supernova becoming black hole. This particular life cycle of a star and their dependence was given by an Indian scientist, Subramaniam Chandrasekhar. We are very proud of him. Yes, and hence he was awarded Nobel Prize for this particular idea of providing solar mass. So any black hole that we see today was once a particular star. Okay, so supermassive stars, when their fuel get exhausted, then their internal core collapses, and when it absorbs everything, leads to a region in space with very high gravitational force, that is nothing but the black hole. Now it is said that the centers of many of the galaxies have black hole in it. Now recently, Event Horizon Telescope found out, they created with various spectrometric study, they created an image of M87 black hole. So that was in news, hence black hole becomes our topic for UPSC Civil Service exam. Yes, for all detailed notes of what black holes, multiple MCQs related to it are posted in the notes supplemented by this particular video. For more such tiny snippets, we'll be uploading all such videos in our further lecture series of lectures. So that's all from my side for today. I hope everybody stays healthy and are fine, and see you soon in class.